Kadhano wanaleta mangolo ndi Diamond. Wewe uko hapa kwa nduthi tukichomeka na njoko na sisi.
Tarumbeta, tarumbeta, tarumbeta.
Danga sanga. Mami, nikase tu hapo.
Hata tumunafanya tusikie sembo liu.
Oh my God.
Mwambie wewe, niko kwa Veneza.
Kamungoje bwanako hapo hizi.
Nini? Wewe una bahati sana. Mimi nakwambia siku hiyo ni vile tu ulini surprise. Siku hiyo ni wewe. Ama waniwachilie tu hapa kitoko. Naweza kuchapa vibaya sana. Ni huruma.
Mtu boda boda anaacha gari tatu. Sasa driving license.
Mzee, mtu wa boda boda si binadamu.
No, like what I'm asking.
Usidharau kazi ya mtu.
Sitakubali mtu yeyote aingilie katika mipango yangu. Kwa hivyo chunga sana unapokanyaga.
Unachokitafuta kutoka kwangu, nitakupatia sawa yako ukae mahali pako.
Ng'ombe amejileta kichinjioni mwenyewe. Kwa hivyo tumaliza naye hapa hapa.
Wewe endelea kuvuruga watu waone vile nitakufanya. Nitakufukuza kama mnyama wewe.
Kwani tumekugutosha? Mimi tumekugutosha ndipo.
Mimi si kesi.
Natamani ningekuwa na muda wa kujadili hilo.
So, I have your passport and your ticket. You're leaving tonight.
Where are we going?
Lavington. Ah, niko mekamkuliza ile burungu.
Lakini si unajua kuenda hivyo.
Oh, niko na askari.
Toa hiyo ring.
Wacha nini na yeye? Yuko nani na?
Kutuzere wakati.
Piga hiyo kitu. Piga!
Jichunge sana na huyo boy. Najua hivyo ndio watu ingizwa boxi ya kibabilo.
Ah, hivi vile unafikiria. Tumetoka worlds tofauti sana. You don't know who I am, you don't know what I do.
In the beginning, there was the Word, and it was all. Then, there was the light, and the world was revealed. With His gifts, war, love, power, death, faith. First chapter of the first book of World will be open again. Newly remastered in HD, Genesis.
Good afternoon and welcome to KBC Lunchtime News on this 13th day of August 2021. A very busy day and the weekend is finally here. We have a comprehensive bulletin right here. And of course, today is a somber day in Kenjokoma where the two brothers who died under unclear circumstances are being laid to rest. Other than that, we have a comprehensive bulletin here, local, international, business and also sports. My name is Ben Troy Njue and Lucy Mwaura will be our sign language interpreter for this afternoon. Kindly, your comments, suggestion, or even where you are watching us from on all our social media platform, and I'll be more than glad to sample some during and at the end of this live cast. Welcome. We now begin at the coast, where Interior Cabinet Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i is giving an update on the businessman, Turkish businessman Ayadin, who was deported. And actually, we will be having that comprehensive report. And right now, he is currently addressing, and we have more.
I think we are reading from the same page, all of us, including the CS. Let that meeting happen. Let everything be said, then you can share. Even if it's in camera, it's allowed by our standing orders. And just like you said earlier about the security in Baringo, that at one time you will have to name and shame some people who are involved in this insecurity themselves and our leaders. Even in this one, the moment you are completely done with it, and we find we can lay our hand on anybody, including the chair of this committee, let us tell Kenyans who the chair is for who he is. Honorable CS.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, honorable members. Thank you very much. I agree with you on all the issues you have raised. We are going to look at particularly this issue about VIP travel and private travel in and out of the country. We look at that. I mean, we are a country that believes and we respect freedoms as expected, but you see, we also have to obey the law and we have to do things for the good order of the country. I agree with you. At some point, you know, in an in-camera session, I can share with you the privileged information that we have shared with some of our sister intelligence and security agencies. And as you know, as a security committee, some of this may be privileged information, but I can tell you without a shadow of doubt and confirm to you that all those issues that have been drawn to our attention, when a sister intelligence or security organization from a neighboring country flags someone, we trust them and they trust us because that's how we work. And when they raise issues, when they tell us this person is keeping the company of money launderers, such as in this particular case, you know, we trust them. And they point out this person has come here, they are engaged with so and so, who already has been, you know, doing criminal activities. We trust them. And that is how we work and succeed. And I can assure you as the committee that is supervising us that we acted in absolute consideration of the security of the country. This particular character is actually an interesting character in terms of security. He's a criminal engaged in illegal activities and so on and so forth. There is no amount of dressing up that anyone can do you know, about this person. And it would actually be shameful for a country and of our size, and a country that enjoys the respect we enjoy in the world, to tolerate these kinds of people around us and try to call them investors. He is not. Thank you.
All right. I think we are done with that matter.
That is the government position shooting straight from the hip. Interior Cabinet Secretary saying the government and the ministry will not apologize for the detainment of controversial Turkish businessman. And of course, they're talking about the businessman having shoddy dealings, and that is why he was deported. Of course, committing that the government will be on top of things when it comes to matter security. Our reporter Junay Karisa is on top of that story and will bring us a much comprehensive report on the government's commitment to matter security. Well, focusing on other matters, the Rotary Foundation, in collaboration with Aqua Clara, a non-governmental organization, are implementing a community sanitization enhancement project in Nyamira County aimed at beefing efforts to curb the spread of coronavirus.
A total of 37 schools and 70 health facilities had been established to benefit under a two-year project which will be located at Rigoma in Nyamira County. The project, estimated to cost 30 million, will include facilities like water tanks for rainwater harvesting, hand washing stations, among others. Speaking during the handing over of water tanks, toilets, and hand washing machines at Nyandochi Ibere Primary School in Burabu, Aqua Clara Chief Operations Officer Peter Kihuria said the county governments of Nyamira, Kisii, and Bomet had received the supplies to enhance sanitation among the community.
And we hope that after all this, that the situation of wash in these communities will improve. What we envision is a child who is coming to school is having proper wash both in the school and at home. And we did donate some hand washing facilities to the county governments of Bomet, Nyamira and Kisii to help with the efforts of combating COVID-19 through hand washing.
Gary Ananda, president of Rotary Club in Gashia, said their role was to ensure prudent utilization of funds allocated for the project.
Our work is to make sure everything has been done according to what the Rotary Foundation guidelines states, and whatever that we hope to achieve with the Global Guard, we make sure that happens.
Elsewhere, 8,000 residents of Okot Village in Isiolo County will no longer experience water shortages after the implementation of a water project in the area. The project, which consists of a borehole, solar-powered pumps and water kiosk, will spare locals from the pain of walking long distances in search of the scarce commodity.
Residents have hailed the project as life-changing, as people from neighboring villages will also benefit from it.
Nashukuru hiyo mradi ya Red Cross kwa sababu ametusaidia sana. Sisi tuka tunaenda mbali kushota maji, hasa sisi wa mama, wewe ndio kila kitu nyumbani. Unaenda mbali kushota maji, bado unaenda kutafutia watoto chakula.
Hatuna shida zai, shida mingi hakuna. Nafikiri tumeokoa kidogo at least kuliko shida ile ya kwenda naye park. Tukawa samburu anatusumbua kwa park, tafuta maji usiku, nyazi, paka zai, paka nafikiri maji ndio ametusaidia zai kwa hapa tu.
Martin Leroy, a local youth, notes that apart from bringing water close to them, the project will also go a long way in reducing tribal conflicts.
Sisi tumepata afueni, tumepata maji kwa karibu, akina mama, at least wamepunguziwa mzigo ya kubeba maji kutoka 10 kilometers. Sasa at least afya imeimarika, watu walikuwa wagonjwa hapo awali, walikuwa wanapelekwa hospitali kila kucha sababu ya ukosefu ya maji na kunywa maji chafu.
Isiolo County CEC in charge of Water, Environment and Sanitation, Josephine Eragai, lauded the Kenya Red Cross and Nestle Kenya for complementing efforts by the county government in ensuring access to clean water for all.
This project is an oasis in a desert, kwa sababu inatumika for multiple use. Ni maji ya kunywa, ni maji ya kulima, ni maji wanatumia katika mifugo, na kwa hivyo ni maji ambayo inawasaidia sana.
She said the devolved unit will work with the organizations to ensure piping is done to bring the water even close to those who are still far from the operational water kiosks. Reporting for Lunchtime News, Amomboy Otiende.
Let's now shift focus to some politics, where presidential aspirant Jimmy Wanjigi is optimistic that he will beat former Prime Minister Raila Odinga to the ODM presidential ticket. Speaking after opening an ODM party office in Ngong, Kajiado, Wanjigi said he is firmly in the race to succeed President Uhuru Kenyatta.
As the countdown to the 2022 general elections continues, presidential aspirant Jimmy Wanjigi is affirming his determination to seek the top seat under ODM party ticket. Speaking after opening an ODM party office in Ngong, Kajiado County, campaign across the Mount Kenya region.
The delegates are a representation of Kenya. ODM is a national party. It does not belong to anybody. It belongs to the people of Kenya. We must change this game, Sindio. We are going to increase that membership in the shortest time you can believe. In the shortest time, we are going to be delegates in Kasarani. The delegates Congress, Indio. And we will defeat any competitor. We are confident. Sisi Indio tuko na numbers, Indio. Kura ziko wapi? Kura ziko wapi? Nani anaweza shinda sisi? Alafu
Wanjigi says he is optimistic ODM will conduct free and fair primaries and that he will defeat party leader Raila Odinga.
This is a democratic party. It has been there in existence since 2005. We are going to make sure the country witnesses democracy at work within its own party. We also believe we are the only ones who can have such a democratic process. I encourage the length and breadth of this country to join this party and be part of shaping the new future that is coming.
The businessman called on Kajiado residents to enroll in the party in large numbers, saying the party is founded on basis of democracy. Kevin Washira, Lunchtime News.
Elsewhere, the families of four men killed by a mob in Kitengela 3 days ago are crying for justice, disputing claims that the young men were criminals. The four were reportedly lynched by villagers of Ekaramuriaki on suspicion of livestock theft and motorcycles and documents they had touched.
At this home in Syokimau, burial preparations for two brothers, 30-year-old Frederick Mureithi and 25-year-old Victor Mwangi, are underway. The charred parts of their motorbikes telling the tales of the ordeal they faced. The two brothers were lynched on the 8th of August alongside their two friends, Mike Onduso, aged 29 years, and Nicholas Chengo, aged 28 years, on suspicion of livestock theft. Their families are now calling for justice, claiming their kin had no criminal records.
Tunajua sio wese. Aya, hii kipikipi ambayo walikuwa naendesha, wakiwa watu wanne, na wako na kipikipi tatu, na wanahutumiwa tiniwezi wa mifugo, unashangaa watu wa mifugo wanaweza kusafirisha mifugo namna gani na kipikipi ambaye haina keria huyo kijana.
They want concerned security agencies to hasten investigations and unravel the motive behind the killing.
Ninge hope ama ninge matarajio yangu ni justice ipatikane, kwa sababu vile tuliona na vile tunajua hii watoto, vile allegation ilikuwa imetokea mbele ati ni wanaweza kuwa ni wahalifu, si wahalifu. Hata polisi wenyewe walisema hao vijana vile walienda na waka observe location of scene, walikuta ati hakuna any evidence ambayo inaonekana hao watu walikuwa wahalifu.
A senior sub-county police commander, Charles Chepkonga, says investigations are underway but so far no arrests have been made.
Natumai haki itapatikana. Hatuwezi sema ya kwamba hawa hata kama walikuwa wezi wako na haki ya wangetakana wapelekwe kotini kama walikuwa ni wezi, lakini kwa sababu waliuawa kwa njia ambayo inatatanisha, so tunaendelea kuchunguza.
Meanwhile, police officers from Kikuyu have arrested a middle-aged woman who is the prime suspect in the killing of a Form 2 student. The two are said to have had an argument over constant power outage before the suspect allegedly stabbed the victim several times, killing him on the spot.
Sasa kijana katoka kuangalia socket breaker ni nini baya mambo na stima. Sasa huyo mwanamke akadhani ni huyo kijana alikuwa anapika na stima na hita. Sasa huyo kijana, huyo mwanamke akaambia kijana asimzuie kupika, akamduga visu tatu, kijana akafariki hapo hapo.
Kikuyu sub-county police commander said that investigations into the killing have commenced. Nancy Okwari, Lunchtime News.
We definitely hope that the four men will have justice and justice be seen to be done. Away from that, the 2022 succession politics are here with us and they are slowly but surely gaining momentum. ANC party leader Musalia Mudavadi is currently right here in Westlands, Nairobi, addressing the press on his economic agenda when it comes to matters economy and debt management in the country.
How do I intend to finance these programs? Is it realistic? Do you want to increase the tax burden on mama mboga? Do you want to increase the tax burden on the small businessman. What is making people angry? Globally, sharing of a container. Is it the less than, they call it LSM, I think there's some importers here. Where our people in Gikomba would be able to share a container in terms of what they bring. Just repeat that?
CVM.
CVM. Now, why would you then create a policy that denies that small person the opportunity to pool together? What? Kenya had a very strong cooperative movement. What is a cooperative movement all about? It's all about pooling together. So you create, make business difficult for them. Now, do you expect them to want to vote for you? These are some of the fundamentals that I say we don't require models. We require dialogue, listening to the people who are doing business, talking to them, understanding their challenges, and finding collective solutions. This is the message that we need to drive home. I was in Treasury for some time. I know a government desires to look for quick collection of revenue, and the target is usually where it pinches most. Energy sector, petroleum products. That is where we go for maybe 50% or even 70% of your costs, energy costs, and nothing but taxes. How are you going to become competitive?
ANC party leader Musalia Mudavadi there addressing the press on his economic agenda when it comes to the 2022 succession politics. And some of the things that I've been able to note is that he's talking about the rising national debt as a thorn in the flesh of many Kenyans and the tax burden on small businesses hurting the economy, which has already been battered by the COVID-19 pandemic. From Westlands, let's now cross over to the well-known T zone of Kianjokoma in Embu County, where the burial ceremony of the two boys or the two brothers who died under unclear circumstances is currently underway. And currently speaking, I can see it's Speaker Justin Muturi.
Democracia era together at the Rikari by the people, for the people of the people. Eh? For the people. Yetugo. At the Rikari Andwe, Yandu. Kwekadia, Komatumekira. Watukedona Kakatiba Jeru. Tokeru tare twauga Kenya Police Force, watokiuga Kenya Police Service. Niyo toro no monde? Eyo niyo? Mwana akalingwa na nzimpo, akagwanze. Murwangira kili kumuli, lika mwana ka uno nduwake, na akemo kumu, I mean surely. Eyo niyo service? Ulea wengi, gali, ilia...
As the National Assembly Speaker Justin Muturi, of course, there addressing all those who are there at the burial in his native tongue, and talking about the government is for the people to serve them. Of course, we have our reporter on the ground who give us a much comprehensive report on the same. From Kianjokoma in Embu County, we now cross over to Umoja, right here in the capital, Nairobi. And you do remember that the government did roll out the mass vaccination program, and our reporter Safin Achieng Ouma is currently following it out. Safin, what's the current status there?
A very good afternoon to you back there in studio Bentro Injue. Thank you so much. We are coming to you live from Umoja 2 Estate right here in Nairobi, just following up on an ongoing mass vaccination exercise on COVID-19. And we've been here since morning just monitoring what is happening at this particular center that is just next to the chief's office in Umoja. And we've seen residents trickling in to get their vaccine by the end of the day, and the exercise seems to be flowing on very well, and some of them have already received their jab and gone home. Others are still coming. It is about one and a few minutes past one, and we are just appreciating what is happening. And I just want us to understand more about this ongoing exercise, and to help us understand is Malkia Abuda. She is the coordinator of community health services in Embakasi. We just want to understand more about this particular exercise being spearheaded by the Nairobi Metropolitan Services. Thank you so much for joining us on KBC Channel 1. Just tell us a little bit about what is happening here.
I'll just hold it. Okay, thank you so much. So today we are trying to increase the access to COVID-19 vaccine. We have tried at least to come closer to the community and bring them the COVID-19 vaccine. So today we are in a center called Umoja 2 Social Hall, and we have invited the community to come for the vaccine. This exercise has been initiated by the Nairobi Metropolitan Services in collaboration to NMAP, which is a national multi-agency for COVID-19 in Nairobi. Yes.
Right, so generally, what is your target, and is this happening only at this particular center, or where else can one get this vaccine?
Apparently, for this exercise, which we are bringing it closer to the community, currently six sub-counties are carrying out the exercise. And these six sub-counties include Embakasi West, where we are. We have Embakasi Central, and we also have Embakasi East, Kamkunji, Makadara, and also Kasarani. So for Embakasi West sub-county, we are having this site, which is Umoja 2. We are having other sites at Buruburu Phase 1 bus terminals. When you go to Embakasi Central, we are having other sites at Matopeni Police Station, just outside, and also at the Chief's Camp in Kayole Central.
So generally, what would you say about how the exercise has gone on so far, and any necessary documentation? There were concerns about others not knowing whether they should come with their IDs or not. How would you comment about how the exercise has gone on?
I'll say this: the exercise is very successful. We are experiencing very good reception from the community. We started at 7, and even by 6 we had residents who had already started coming in for the exercise. So I'll say the community is receiving the vaccine very well, and I will encourage for more to come, because we are conducting the exercise from today, Friday, up to Sunday. However, from Monday you can also access the vaccine in our public health facilities, and I'll urge the community to come for the vaccine because it is free, and we are giving to all ages from 18 years and above. So we are welcoming everybody who did not have an opportunity to get the vaccine to come. And the public needs to know we are giving both the first dose, and also the ones who want to complete their second dose. Yes.
Okay. What would you say about, as an assurance about the safety of this vaccine? There are fears about the side effects. Some are still not sure whether they should take it or not. And also, does it mean that after one has taken the vaccine, they are free and now they can be reckless about their way of life?
So first and foremost, I'd like to assure the public the vaccine is really safe, and it has been recommended by the international bodies and also our Ministry of Health. And also, some of us received this vaccine way back when it started, and we are still here and we are really okay. So the vaccine is very safe, and I'll encourage everybody to get the vaccine because it's safe for us. And after the vaccine, we still need to continue observing the preventive measures for COVID-19, which include we ensure that we maintain hand washing. We still need to continue wearing our masks, observing social distance. So the measures still stand. The vaccine is just to help boost our immune, but it doesn't mean after being vaccinated you cannot get COVID-19. So vaccine is okay, it will boost our immune, but kindly let the members of the public observe the preventive measures for COVID-19.
Yes.
Thank you so much for your time, Malkia. There you have it. I have been talking to the coordinator for community health services right here, this particular area. And what she's saying, she's insisting on the fact that even after you receive your vaccine, you have not received the clean bill of health. You still need to adhere to the COVID-19 safety protocols to protect not just yourself, but the people around you. We will be going on just to continue monitoring what is happening at this particular center and also finding out more information about the mass vaccination exercise. But for now, it's back to you in studio, Bentro Njue. My name is Safina Ching Ouma, and my cameraman is Waweru.
Thank you, Safin and Waweru, live from Umoja Estate, where the Nairobi Metropolitan Services, in collaboration with the national government, have embarked on a mass vaccination exercise in 6 sub-counties. We're talking about Embakasi to Kasarani, so the Buruburu also also there. And as you have seen, is that long queues are being witnessed, and the exercise is going on smoothly. So kindly, get a chance, you visit the centers that are offering that vaccine. And also they said that they will be in those 6 sub-counties in the next 3 days. So from Monday you can access the vaccine at any public health facility in your locality. On that note, we're taking our first breather, but when we come back with more news, including a very interesting conversation in business.
On your max, say go.
This week on Surura, we visit Kenya's home of champions. Meet a custodian of Kipsigis culture.
This is a bladder.
Wamu ne tugul.
Welcome to Rivertex East Africa.
And tour one of East Africa's textile giants. And yes, that's coming right up on
Surura. Find your adventure.
This week, the spotlight is on Ben Soul, the face of Soul Generation.
Lucy, I love you.
The artist is a multi-instrumentalist, talented songwriter, and soulful singer.
Lucy.
The versatile musician has hit singles like Lucy, Forget You, favorite song under his belt.
I love you like the sunshine in the morning when I'm yawning.
Catch Ben Soul on Easy Friday at 9:45 p.m. with Shiksha Arora only on KBC Channel 1.
Okay.
A lesson found for you. I found her crying by the administration block.
You are different. Why are you calling Lucy? For just leave me alone.
Catch a big woman crying so much in public. Feel free to keep the handkerchief.
Hello. Can I help you?
Finally, someone who speaks my language. I was hoping someone would come and ask that. So, can you?
At a friend, I know too well not to agree to that at all, at all. Nay, I am not prepared for your evil motives today, Vivi. Please, leave, leave.
Viv!
Is Viv? What's the question, Fifi?
Vivi!
Classmates, every Saturday on KBC.
A tremendous
scars. He's been in these wars and wild, no holes barred fights.
This is about real wrestling, guys, training in the dungeon, sacrificing your life, 24 years of wrestling, and that's, guys, something that nobody in the world understands. The pressure either makes you or breaks you.
University of Eastern Africa Baraton will be holding its 39th graduation ceremony virtually, commencing on Thursday 12th to the D-Day on Sunday 15th of August 2021 from 9 a.m. Catch the virtual event live on KBC, Baraton TV and Hope Channel. University of Eastern Africa Baraton, a chartered Seventh-day Adventist Church institution of higher learning.
Welcome back and thanks for keeping it KBC. In case you just joined us, this is KBC Lunchtime News. Moving on, power interruptions in Narok County will soon be a thing of the past once the construction of a 132 kilovolt Olkaria Narok transmission power line is completed. Kenya Electricity Transmission Company engineer Nicholas Kandie says the project is 84% complete, with the remaining section to be completed by the end of the year.
The power line is expected to be completed by November this year, with 54 kilometers of the 68 kilometers power line already completed.
Have done most of the foundation, actually all foundations are done. We are remaining with 20 tower erections to be completed.
The power line is expected to do away with power outages within Narok County and its environs once it is complete.
The power that we are using in Narok is not adequate. That is why we have power fluctuations and surges during peak hours.
Narok County Commissioner Evans Achoki says the Narok Development Implementation Committee is working closely with Kenya Electricity Transmission Company to beat the November deadline, assuring Narok residents of improved power supply once the project is operational.
So I want to take this opportunity to assure residents of Narok that in 2 months' time, power fluctuation in Narok town will end and they will be adequate, stable and reliable supply of power in Narok and Narok town and its environment.
For Lunchtime News, I'm Brian Munyoki.
Women smallholder farmers in Migori County have embraced community-based groups as a way of gaining knowledge of farming activities. The family says the benefits of pulling together under one umbrella have helped them become socially accountable to each other.
Honey, green grams, Chinese cabbage, lettuce, broccoli, these are just some of the products that are being sold here in Nairobi suburbs and beyond, straight from some of Kenya's bountiful regions. Currently, Kenyan farmers continue to struggle to gain access to markets for their produce. Agriculture contributes 31% to Kenya's gross domestic product. Still, there seems to be a unique way to connect farmers to market.
Now, when we want to sell soya, we sell as a team or we sell as an AC. And it is very easy for us to locate the venue.
Meet Lilian Akinyi, a beneficiary in Migori County of one such program called Alpha Chama, a community-based program with about 600 members that empower farmers to become better farm managers and producers of quality produce.
Fachama has really assisted me personally, and it has also assisted us as a group. It has really helped us because now when we want to sell soya, we sell as a team or we sell as an AC, and it is very easy for us to locate the venue.
apart from organizing farmers and providing soft credit savings and loans facilities. From 500 shillings, this particular community-based system also helps farmers in their social lives, allowing them to have peace of mind while at the same time improving their living status.
When we are in a group, we also have another, we were talking about getting people into two buddy system. Buddy system means that when I'm sick, the next person, my neighbor, who is just Eunice, will at least help me.
Alfajiri Limited founder and CEO Tomoko Yakushigawa says the demand for farm products in major cities and lack of preservatives prompted the group to start a grocery business in Nairobi. Customers range from locals, foreigners, and even corporate entities, thereby ensuring steady market for the farmers back in Migori.
We want to have more branches, and so through retail business, we want to have more market for farmers, ensure market for farmers. So right now, we already created this model, and also we want to have like a model for only cereals, like simple kiosks, so that we can expand a lot of retail sales channel. And as we expand the sales channel, it is also possible, very possible, that we also increase the number of farmers who can be ensured the market with us.
From butternuts to carrots to white onions to honey, peanut butter, we have here avocados and a very wide variety of passion fruits. And here we have green grams and beans and groundnuts. And of course, another variety of oranges and tamarind. And not forgetting some very freshly squeezed pineapple mint juice, freshly squeezed with love from Migori County. Let me just get a sense of how it tastes. I can actually taste the sun that made this grow.
Alan Aoko, Lunchtime News.
Thanks, Aoko, for that report. Further afield, Samsung heir Lee Jong-yong has been released from a South Korean prison and is now on parole after 207 days in jail after being convicted of bribery and embezzlement in January. The case, which also involved the country's former president Park Geun-hye, saw the Samsung heir serve only half of his jail term. Details of this and other stories from across the globe.
Samsung heir and de facto head since 2014 says he deeply apologizes for the damage he has caused to reporters while leaving prison. The 53-year-old was sent to prison for 2.5 years by a high court earlier this year. He was accused of paying 43 billion won to two non-profit foundations operated by his friend Choi Soon-sil in exchange for political support. The support bought was alleged to include backing for a controversial Samsung merger, which paved the way for Lee to become eventual head of the conglomerate. Meanwhile, technology giant Amazon's TV and film business is moving production of its multi-million dollar Lord of the Rings series to the UK from New Zealand. The as-yet-untitled fantasy was part of a plan by the company to expand its production space and consolidate its footprint in the UK. Amazon Studios spent $465 million on the first season of the show, with four more seasons expected to be made that would make it one of the most expensive series in television history. Finally, a hacker who stole $600 million worth of cryptocurrency has now returned most of the stolen assets. Polygon Network confirmed on Twitter that $268 million worth of Ether tokens has now been recovered. The hacker disclosed offers Polygon Network made to them, including a $500,000 pay to return the stolen assets and immunity for the authorities. Other money outstanding also includes a 13.37 Ether tip, which the hacker sent to a user who warned them that the Tether tokens had been frozen by its developer. Despite the progress so far, some of the money is still outstanding. Reporting for Lunchtime News, my name is Hibak Said.
In sports, newly promoted Brentford expect to have striker Ivan Tooney fit for the English Premier League opener against Arsenal tonight. Meanwhile, European champions Chelsea have re-signed striker Romelu Lukaku for a club record 97.5.